desde los años, de los primeros años de la revolución en el poder, hubo alzamientos en la zona del Escambray y rebeldía o protesta, grupos conspirando a lo largo y ancho de Cuba, y por eso miles de prisioneros fueron a las cárceles, fueron capturados, llevados a las cárceles, y fusilamiento también.
José
Jorge Luis, Jorge Luis Pérez,
Jorge Luis
Pérez
Antunes.
Antunes es el sobrenombre.
Antunes es el nickname.
Antunes,
this is a man actually has been a spiritual and a political in Cuba. Antunes. And he enjoyed their organization as from that debt, and try to unify with them to help, you know. And his man is a friend, personal friend to Che, and he say, okay, do you please, you guarantee me, you know, I'm going to bring my brother-in-law, you're not going to do anything. Don't worry, I give you my word, bring it down, tell everybody, surrender it, and we're going to put it in jail for a few years or whatever, but it's not going to be executed. He bring it down, he bring it to Che, and the other friends too, and they, and put everyone in the fire squad. The men, the same night, killed a few people in the in the embassy, and he, you know, left Cuba. That is the kind of the integrity Che and these people have. They don't have no integrity. They don't have, you know, nothing to.
Mi memoria no se ha detenido mucho. Y yo cuando mandé la carta ya estaba desarmado. Lo que sucede es lo siguiente, que cuando el camino me detiene, me dice, yo vengo avergonzado, Uber. Vengo avergonzado porque me mandan a esto y tú sabes lo que pensamos. Tú.
Uber, let me say that because I want to tell you something, maybe you don't even know. He say, well, Camilo coming to arrest me. He coming to me and he tell me, Uber, I coming very ashamed of myself because I don't want to do this. They sent me to do this. And I really, really don't want to do this. Continue. He said, don't worry about it, Camilo. You have to do what you have to do. Do your duty. And it's okay. You know, I take care of myself. I got 12 years old. I in Cojima. In the house, you know, where Castro, Fidel, Raul, y toda esa gente se reunían ahí de a sus parrandas y su Bacardí y todo eso. Camilo, le dicen a Camilo que te vaya a buscar a ti. You have to bring Uber over here. Yo estaba ahí en ese grupo. El Che se ofrece. No, Fidel, no mandes a Camilo. Yo voy a ir a buscarlo. No, le dice Fidel al Che y a Raúl. Ninguno de ustedes puede ir a buscar a Uber porque Uber no va a regresar con ninguno de ustedes. Yo conozco a Uber. Tú tienes que ir a buscar a Uber y convencerlo de que no va a haber problema y que todo va a estar bien. Che, say no. Camilo, you don't should go. Fidel, let me go and bring Uber. Raúl say, I go with Che. And Castro turn around then and he say, no. Either you guys cannot go and get Uber because Uber not going to come back with you guys. Camilo is the one is going to go and talk to him and it's not going to be no problem. Camilo turned around because Camilo loved this man. And he tell it to Fidel, do you sure nothing is gonna happen to Uber? And he say, what's the matter with you, Camilo? Do you think I'm going to hurt my own people? Do you think I will hurt you? I'm not going to hurt you or Uber or anybody else and my team. The reason he did that because he trusts Castro, he got Fidel. And the plan behind the whole thing is to these people, the people behind the comandante, kill Camilo, they get arrested to Camilo, and then they accuse him to be responsible for Camilo's death. They get arrested to two at the same time.
Nosotros eso conocimos que una compañía que tenía Fidel de fuerzas tácticas en el aeropuerto la habían mandado a que se movilizara y se sublevara contra el ejército. Y al jefe de policía, que era amigo mío, también le ordenaron que la fuerza de policía se movilizara y se rebelara contra el ejército, así buscando combate para que hubiera unos cuantos muertos.
Exacto.
Así fuimos, compañía por compañía, diciendo, no, esta es una trampa.
Yeah, don't do anything. He got a man in the roof with a 50 caliber, and he said, Commander, anybody coming through this compound, we will kill everybody.
And he said, no, you're crazy. You don't see, this is a trap. Don't shoot, don't do anything. Just let it get me coming in, let it do what we have to do, but don't shoot a single bullet here. This is a trap. That is how the whole thing happened. Personal pilot from Castro, from Fidel Castro, fly behind Camilo's plane, where he leave, come away to come back to La Habana, and he shoot the plane down, and they tell the whole people in Cuba that Camilo is lost in the ocean. And his father tell the story, and he say they hear how the pilot later on have a very really bad conflict with his conscience, and he say, I don't want to do that. I don't want to do that. But, you know, they made me do it. They made me do it.
Queremos guerra civil. No queremos derramamiento de sangre. No queremos violencia. Porque creemos que el pueblo cubano vuelva a ser dueño de su destino y que haya elecciones libres y que haya se forme un gobierno de transición con los que estén representados diferentes grupos y para que comience a fundarse la república otra vez y Cuba vuelva a recuperarse. Y seguramente que habrá que mandar de emergencia mucha comida y muchas cosas para Cuba el día que haya el cambio, sí, porque el hambre...
Tenemos que estar preparados para eso.
El hambre plantea por...
Let me translate that, and we're going to close it up. What he's saying is, we're not looking here for anything. We don't want to be political positions in Cuba. We don't looking for divisions. All what we want is everybody is be able to be free and to come back to the normal constitution as a Cuba is 50 years before Castro, and come back to be a good country, and everybody got freedom and live well, and you know they don't have to play a lottery in order to just leave Cuba as a citizen of Cuba.
Un gobierno de transición que esté representado a diferentes grupos de oposición.